国际焦点先来关注，美国参院通过了原屋包裹法案，而根据 CNN 的报道，总统拜登最快在周三就会签署生效。这10亿美元的武器援助将包括次针防空飞弹、布雷德利战车跟海马斯火箭炮。
乌克兰顿内茨克，俄罗斯坦克得寸进尺，步步紧逼。在这一座名为西米哈伊利夫卡的小村庄，可能是俄罗斯的最新战利品。俄罗斯高举旗帜，宣称已经拿下，但是乌克兰否认，还说有15%到20%的范围还在控制中，而且全村都在乌克兰的火力控制范围内。乌克兰前线依然打得辛苦，节节败退，士气低落。就连第二大城哈尔科夫，240公尺高的电视塔都被俄罗斯打中，直接断一半。乌克兰研判应该是被俄罗斯的 KH-59 巡弋飞弹给击中，而哈尔科夫也不止一个地方遇袭。
О половині першої години ночі росіяни здійснили запуск ракети С-300 з території Білгородської області. Щонайменше дві ракети влучили у Шевченківському районі.
满地弹壳，还留有大弹坑，30辆的汽车和民宅全毁。奥德萨则是有民宅遇袭，烧成一团火球。乌东的康斯坦丁诺夫卡同样遭到俄罗斯飞弹打来，民众当街见血痛苦呻吟。乌克兰大城市和东部地区每天轮流哀轰。
That's one of the reasons Ukraine has made air defenses a top priority.
到底何时可以等到救兵？终于有一丝曙光。
On this vote, the yeas are 79, the nays are 18.
美国拖了大半年的国会补充法案，当中包含610亿美元的援乌预算，终于在参议院闯关成功。
We tell our allies, we will stand with you. We tell our adversaries, don't mess with us.
外媒更报道，只要表决通过，马上就有10亿美元的援助快递乌克兰。
Urgently needed supplies of ammunition, artillery rounds, as well as air defense systems and long-range missiles are expected to be airlifted to Ukraine within days after Congress finally approved a military aid package.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Congress. Thank you, America.
根据两位美国官员匿名透露，这十亿美元的军援包含布雷德利战车、标枪飞弹、次针防空飞弹和海马斯多管火箭炮的弹药，以及其他关键需求。这渴望先帮乌克兰纾解燃眉之急，不过乌克兰最想要的恐怕还是美国的长城飞弹 ATACMS。
Four priorities, they are key.Protection of the sky, modern artillery, long-range capability, and ensuring that American support packages arrive as soon as possible. And today's result is that all the dots have been dotted in the agreements on the ATACMS for Ukraine.
而现在不只是美国，英国要提供对乌克兰的史上最大笔军援，再加码5亿英镑，包含400辆军车及1600枚防空飞弹，还有长城飞弹、暴风之影。
Including small arms ammunition, more Storm Shadow missiles. Those long-range missiles that have proved critical for Ukraine in its sort of deep battle behind enemy lines. Over 60 boats. This will boost the existing commitment from the UK from around £2.5 billion to over £3 billion. That's about 3.7.
英国现在已经成为继美国、德国之后对乌克兰的第三大军援国，甚至有些新型武器，就连英国正规军队都还没。普遍使用，就先在乌克兰上战场。像是这一套 Marlin 岩焰轻型多功能飞弹，乌军抢先用，凸显出英国想要在俄乌战事中掌握话语权的意图，但还是要考量现实。
This is a time when everyone is under pressure. I think you will see Rishi Sunak on these visits to Poland and Germany facing difficult conversations about how quickly the UK can boost defence production.
尤其美国年底将大选，如果川普真的当选，欧洲防卫是不是只能靠自己？ 这让北约国家提心吊胆，军援承诺能兑现多少还是未知数。 TVBS 新闻综合报道。
美国多所名校挺巴勒斯坦示威，冲突升温。哥伦比亚大学因为校园被挺巴的团体扎营霸占，全面改为线上授课。纽约大学呢，则是爆发学生跟警察的激烈冲突。哈佛大学则是被迫暂时关闭校园，打了200天的战争还是没停歇。
轰的来袭，引爆巨响，加沙南部拉法又遭以军攻击。居民说，攻击前不久才收到以军的警告通知，许多人反应不及，帐篷又被摧毁。以军在犹太逾越节期间攻击不手软，也锁定北部地区猛轰。一秒炸毁了加萨市阿尔沙哈巴一栋建筑，同一时间以色列南部也不平静。周二遭巴勒斯坦武装分子发射火箭攻击，尽管以色列拦截所有火箭弹，还是有残骸波及储藏室，冒出浓烟。学生和警察爆发激烈推挤，以哈战争进行的同时，美国大学的挺巴示威越扩越大。22号起，纽约大学跟进访校哥伦比亚大学生搭帐篷隔空声援巴勒斯坦人。却因为人潮越聚越多，纽约警察决定派人清理现场，还有学生遭数袋反绑带上警车。
There is no place for hate in this city. I don't care if it's anti-Semitism, Islamophobia, anti-Sikhism.
发起示威的除了有哥伦比亚大学和纽约大学，同样位在东岸的麻省理工学院和哈佛大学也陆续响应。这波示威还蔓延到中西部的俄亥俄州、密西根、明尼苏达大学，以及西岸的加州大学伯克莱分校，在西雅图连高中生都挺身而出。
Here at Emerson, we're seeing this large crowd of just over 20 tents set up here in this alleyway leading up to the college signage, food, water. This is a very organized demonstration happening here.
为了平息纷争，各大州一起取消实体课程，改线上授课。哈佛大学中心草坪也紧急关闭。校园中两派的肢体冲突越来越常发生。
Don't touch me! Don't touch me!
My friend on Saturday night was full-blown assaulted. He had, you know, he was shoved around.
各大知名校友兼金主 NFL 新英格兰爱国者老板克拉夫特现在对母校的状况也看不下去，扬言要撤销赞助金。
I just can't believe in New York City at Columbia University, Jewish students.Are afraid to go to classes.
但不止校园不平静。周三甚至有许多挺巴示威者来到参院多数党领袖舒默住家，抗议美国通过的外援法案形同助长战争。
Senator Schumer.Your Jewish constituents and the vast majority of the U.S. demands stop arming Israel.
以色列在西岸的反恐争议也没有停止。画面中，这名高龄78岁的巴勒斯坦美国民众阿萨德，2年前在以军旗下的犹太永恒营不当拘留，最后不幸枉死。
Like this, they're pushing you down like this, walking up the road like this, pushing.
他当时也被关押的弟弟接受 CNN 采访，指证看到哥哥突然倒地不起，结果以军明明发现，却放任不管。
A soldier put his hand on his neck to check for a pulse, Abu Muhammad says, then left in a hurry. When I was sure they were gone, I checked him. He had no pulse.And I sent for the doctor.
惹出争议的犹太永恒营，因为允许极端正统派加入，作风向来相当残忍。另外，以色列人质家属也继续上街抗议，他们感觉救援进度像是被摆在一旁，整个国家和和平越离越远。
rebuild the country again. The anti-Semitism in the world is rising, and we Jews, we only have one place to be here, and this is the land, and we have to rebuild the land and live here in peace.
美国国务院发言人则透露，哈马斯最近突然又改变协议的要求，导致以哈谈判陷入僵局，短时间内恐怕难以立即休战。点新闻综合报道。
再来看美国的这个问题，他们的接有人数不断攀升，2023年已经有65万人无家可归，同比增加了12%。奥勒冈州的一个小镇为了驱赶移民，制定了反露宿法，那么遭控违宪。另外，房价物价持续攀升，也让游民越来越多。
放眼望去，绿油油的草皮上一顶顶帐篷，住在里面的全都是游民。原警一看到，立马上前递黄单驱赶他们，游民只好无奈打包走人。美国奥勒冈州南部的小镇格兰帕兹最近声名大噪，因为这座城市为了驱赶街友，特别制定了反露宿法。
Hundreds of homeless people in Grants Pass began setting up encampments in public parks. In 2013, the city stepped up its enforcement of anti-camping laws.Banning anyone from sleeping outside with any kind of bedding, including a blanket, pillow, or even a cardboard box.
格兰帕兹大约有40000人口，其中600人露宿街头，当地却没有市立收容所，只能仰赖私人慈善团体所设立的机构。在居民开始抱怨街友随地大小便后，市府从2013年开始加强执法取缔。
I have a lot of tickets from Grants Pass. I was almost $5,000 worth.
只要违反这项反露宿法，就得吃上295美元，大约台币9600块罚单，累犯甚至会被判20天监禁。
We all are out here struggling, and there's no place for us. Like literally, it's like we're made to move every 5 days, and if we don't, we get ticketed, kicked out of the park, and arrested.
无家可归者忙于寻找合法安歇的地方，但收容所的床位少之又少，一旦在街头吃罚单，根本缴不出罚款，间接损害个人信用，让未来找工作或租房难上加难，人生就此陷入恶性循环。
It's pretty much just destroyed my credit, and you know, when a person's so far down and they're just trying to get ahead, they can't.
针对市府的取缔，三名街友一状告上法院，主张这样的做法违反美国宪法第八修正案，不可处以过重罚金，不得施加残酷或不正常的处罚。
Courts in the West have found that banning people from camping in public spaces, if shelter space is lacking, amounts to cruel and unusual punishment.
但格林帕兹市却不服，提出上诉，官司最终闹到联邦最高法院。九名大法官22号进行辩论，其中6名保守派大法官认为这并非法官管权范围，但只占3席的自由派大法官明显站在游民这一边。
That person cannot take himself and himself only, and you know can't take a blanket and sleep someplace without it being a crime.It seems like you're criminalizing a status.
联邦最高法院预计将在6月30号做出裁决，这将影响全美街友的命运。因为根据美国都发部最新统计数据，2023年全美游民人数增加12%，有65.3万人无家可归，其中加州就占1/3，有超过180000人露宿街头。
We have about 9,000 children.Who are homeless in Los Angeles. Some of them are in and out of school, some of them attend school, but many are living in cars and RVs. One of the fastest growing sectors of the unhoused population are senior citizens, people in their 60s and 70s. They get priced out of the market and they wind up unhoused.
但就算不是街友，甚至还有工作，许多美国教师连打3份工都快付不起越来越昂贵的房租。
I thought, you know, by this point in my career, I'd be a little bit more financially stable. The salaries didn't really keep up with the cost of living.
这名老师说，想要住在离学校近一点的地方，现在都变成一种奢侈。
Do we want teachers that?Stay after school, maybe coach sports, get involved in school activities, or do we want teachers that, right after the bell rings, that they have to get in their car and start their hour and a half commute?
刚入行的新手老师不只要通勤，还逼不得已得和其他五名教师一起住在一栋由教堂改建的共享住宿。
My room is right here.
Okay. I'm getting the sense of like a dorm room.
She pays $1,000 a month for this room. A studio apartment in the area would cost more than double that.
全美有将近八成的公立学校留不住老师，主要原因就是高房租和低薪。为了解决这种状况，许多城市像是迈阿密、芝加哥和洛杉矶的市政府打算出手补助建商多新建平价住宅，专门提供给教师居住。 TVB 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。